Yuri Vardanyan, 224 clean and jerk at 82.5 kilograms body weight. I was doing 2 days ago an Instagram poll and I was asking your opinion between Yuri Vardanyan and Angel Genchev from Bulgaria, Tureviev. I think these two, they had some very great numbers in their clean and jerk and they was very, very special. So based on the results, you chose Yuri Vardanyan, and in this video I will review Yuri Vardanyan 224 clean and jerk. This video that it's on YouTube, it's not very good for analysis because the cameraman it's switching the direction and it's showing more as his face instead of filming everything to see all body and what he's doing with his legs in every face. So because of the footage, the analysis it will be not perfect. I was heard it first time about Vardanyan from my coach, who was a big fan of Yuri Vardanyan, and was tell all the time, go and watch Yuri Vardanyan if you want to see a very good weightlifter and try to do like him. When I was finding YouTube and I finally find a lift with Yuri Vardanyan, I was first time I was not so impressed about his technique. He don't have a very good technique, but he was doing some impressive numbers and he has a very good confidence in himself, and he was having very good power and strength. I was hearing that Yuri Vardanyan was doing in training 350 kilograms deadlift. So if you look here, he's not using a belt of something, and it's seeing that his back it's very solid. And I think this is also a reason that it's able to clean that close from his front, because probably his leg was not so strong, but definitely his back was like guys from plus category, like the guys like Lasha Talahatse, that I don't think he was doing 350 deadlift or something like that. It's a crazy number. So let's watch first time at his 224. He's using a dynamic start. This is a classic dynamic start when the athlete it's focusing right above the barbell, and when it's ready it's going down, it's grabbing the barbell and it's lifting from the ground. So it's a very classic dynamic start here. Very easy barbell in first pull, was bouncing a bit in the bottom and after that was going up. Nice one. So if we go from start position, he's using a dynamic start. He has a very narrow grip. From what it's in here, it's a very bad camera angle. If you see, it's compensating a lot with his hips. His hips are very high and it's seeing that it's not based too much on his leg, and it's trying to switch all the weight on his hips and back. He's remaining very nice with his arms, are straight. Barbell was a bit far here when he was passing the knees, but this it's happened also because he was lifted a lot his bum from the start position. He's using a mid tight contact. He's remaining very good with his arms. In power position the arms are straight, very straight. Shrugging a bit the shoulders, the elbows are going a bit back. He has a very smooth transition. And barbell it's not crashing on him at all. It's very good here, the transition, I really like it. He's completing very good the turnover of the elbows. The elbows are fully turnovered. This is very good. Was bouncing here a bit in the bottom and after that he was going up from the hole. He was maintaining very good the position. The elbows was remaining very good. It's impressive that it's doing this lift without having a belt. So I really like this type of weightlifter where they don't have too much accessory on them. This means that they work very well in training and they are don't doing too much mistakes and they know what they are doing. Impressive front rack here at this weight and at this barbell. It's very stable, and it's obvious here that his low back and core are very strong, because he's staying very good in the front rack. With this weight, it's impressive, and at this body weight, he's keeping the barbell like more in fingertips, but it's something the middle hand and fingertips. I like that it's maintaining the elbows in same position at the dip. The dip here was pretty long for this weight. He was doing a pretty long dip compared with his other lift. He's going straight up on the drive. I like that at the dip he was having the weight more on the heels. He was not going in front at all. This is very good. He's extending here very good. He's using here a very short split, but if you notice from where his legs, if image, because we don't see because this angle it's very bad, but from there the back foot is remaining almost there, and it's only moving a bit in front, his front foot. So this is a very good footwork. I like this one. Very small split jerk from this weight. This has show us how strong he is and how much he was driving the barbell up. I really like his low back position here. He's maintaining his pelvis neutral. It's very good. His arms are looking a bit banded, like they are in the weird position a bit, but that I think this is because of his wrist, because if we see here, his wrist has hyperextended there in the back, are too much in the back, and probably was having there some hypermobility or something, or just was learning like that when he was young, and he was remaining in this style probably because he was getting very strong like that. Normally it's good to have your wrist like in the middle, not straight, not too much extended, to be like in the middle. This is the perfect grip for the snatch and the jerk as well when you have the barbell overhead. The recovery was very good, of course, with front foot. Vardanyan was doing here very big results. These numbers are very hard to achieve in training for a weightlifter, even in your mind. It's very hard to do them, but to do them in the competition. So even if you take everything you want to do, everything you want in training, it's only a few people it will be able in the lifetime to achieve these results at this body weight. This was my analysis of Yuri Vardanyan, 224 clean and jerk, a great athlete, a great weightlifter, one of the best.